Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Duo Wang. I'm from a computer laboratory of University of Cambridge. And today I'm going to be presenting to you about the bridging computer science and neuroscience towards a new understanding of diagrammatic reasoning. So first, what is diagrams? So we humans actually use diagrams to represent complex concepts and help to reason about them in our everyday life. So basically, you can use a map to actually help you navigate through a city. In your high school physics class, you can use a pulley system diagram to help you solve the pulley system problem. And in this specific example, you can use the Euler diagram to solve what is a very classical logical task, which is called syllogism reasoning, such as all B is A, all C is B, therefore all C is A. So all C is A is a conclusion. So it can be represented in Euler diagram as this three diagram. And so for my PhD project, I aim to train a deep neural network that does this diagrammatic reasoning and also to correlate it with the real human brain activities measured in fMRI, using fMRI. So I was first introduced to you about the neural network for diagrammatic reasoning. So basically, it's also the very popular encoder-decoder architecture, which the decoder takes two diagrams that represents the two premises in the syllogism. And this architecture will generate a diagram that represents a conclusion of this syllogism. So basically, this trained combining the variational autoencoder and the generative adversarial network training objective. If you want to know more about this training objective, you can talk to me at my poster. And so the next stage is for me to correlate this neural network with the fMRI measured human brain activity. So currently we are carrying out the fMRI experiment. And so the basic idea is you let the human beings see the same diagram as the neural network perceive. And so you can take out a layer from the neural network and you can correlate them with a certain region, certain voxels in your fMRI measured response. And you're able to build a correlation of, for example, you can use the classical canonical correlation analysis or some more advanced correlation analysis to actually identify the regions that actually we human use for diagrammatic reasoning. And actually you can use this to see if the neural network is really a good correlates of the human brain. This is my presentation. Thank you.